Yes, Mr. LePew.
Please, 2 minutes.
I'll need 10 minutes, at least. Where is Mr. Holst?
Don't worry about it.
Who is that woman? I can't have people looking over my shoulder.
I'll explain all that to you, okay? Go ahead and get into place, dude.
Time it for me, Philip.
Yes, Mr. LePew.
Reset up. Lights down.
Jesus.
Damn it, Philip.
Sorry, Mr. LePew.
Music up. Black it out. Okay, people, energy and pace. This is our final chance before we face the audience. Make it count.
Hey, I'm not ready yet.
Sorry, Mr. LePew.
What a sad day for the Barringtons. Especially Lord Barrington, who was found horribly murdered as he ate cheese in the library. Gouda cheese, sliced thin. I have slaved for this family since I was a young boy, as my father did before me, and his father before him, and my grandmother beside him, and my mother beneath her. Oh, the door is chiming. I must answer it, as I have done since I was a young boy, like my father did before me, and his father before him, and my grandmother beside him, and my mother beneath her. Ah, young Alexander Barrington.
Ah, Drews, kindly Drews, ever faithful, ever true.
And who is this young woman I see before me?
Jules, I'd like you to meet my new bride, Penelope.
Don't you mean Penelope?
You're so right, Jules. I just call her darling.
A delight.
The delight is mine.
Jules, it's a sad day for the Barringtons.
May I take your coats?
Is mother about?
She's been under quite a strain. Finding the Lord like that. Face down in the Gouda, sliced thin.
Poor mother.
Poor thing.
How is she?
Hasn't touched a dairy product since.
And my sister, Bet. Has she arrived yet?
She's come, sir. Arrived this morning, singing out loud like a little bird.
How odd.
Not really. She has a beautiful voice.
I'll see if the Lady Barrington is up and around. May I take your suitcase? Please help yourself to the sherry. It will warm you from the winter chill. He exits up left. Ow!
Oh, Alexander. There's a chill in the air. A chill about this house. An evil chill. I'm frightened. Help me. Help me.
You're all right. As long as I'm around, Penelope.
I feel better knowing that you're near.
I'll never leave you. Never. The snow. Falling snow. White snow. Snow everywhere. Snow. Each flake different and unique in a melancholy way. Yet together, a mass of constant white.
What are you trying to tell me, Alexander?
I was born and raised in this house, Penelope. I lived here my entire life, with the exception of school, and college, and day camp, and the week I was kidnapped by the man in the blue mask. This home is my blood. This home and the snow. There's nothing I would do to keep it. Nothing.
Anything? What do you mean by? Anything.
Who the hell are you?
Me?
Yes.
Inspector Mounds.
Beg your pardon?
Inspector Mounds, Scotland Yard. I'm here investigating your late father's death.
And what have you found?
Nothing yet. But we know he did not die accidentally.
You mean?
Murder!
snow.
Would you mind answering some questions, Mr. Barrington?
I have nothing to hide.
The reading of the will tell the tale.
Meaning?
Exactly, what was your sister Beth's relationship with your late father?
Marvelous, Inspector. We got along divinely. I was like a daughter to him, and he was like a father to me. I miss him so. It's hard to believe he's really gone.
I say, he's not really gone. He's still in the study. They haven't come for the body yet. Snow and all.
Hello, brother.
Hello, Bet.
You must be the new one.
Delighted. What did you mean, new one?
Didn't dear brother tell you? You're number 13. Unlucky number 13.
13? 13 what?
Why, 13 wives, you little petulant child.
I thought I was the first.
Naive, foolish, petulant child.
You are the first, Penelope. The first that meant anything.
What happened to them, Alexander? Were they pretty?
They were all lovely. Especially Gwendolyn. With her fair skin, tight sweaters, and massively large jugs.
Where are they now?
She was buried with them.
You mean?
Ten.
You mean?
Murder!
I always meant to tell you this, dear.
Murder? All of them?
Not at the same time, individually.
Interesting, Mr. Barrington. If you'll excuse me.
I was never convicted.
Ow! Juries can be bought. You never did explain that blood on your socks.
Mr. Barrington, your mother cannot wait to see you. I told her you had arrived, and her face lit up like the shining sun in the noonday sun. Presenting Lady Barrington. Presenting Lady Barrington. She cannot wait to see you, Mr. Barrington. Her face, Lady Barrington.
I can hear Mother coming now.
Presenting Lady Barrington.
Where the hell is she?
I shall go and find her.
Wait, stop it, stop it. Where the hell is Miss Crawford, for Christ's sakes? Philip!
Mr. LePew, please, we're rehearsing.
Am I the only one who realizes that? We open tomorrow night. Philip!
Yes, Mr. LePew?
Where the hell is Miss Crawford? We could have gone out for a sandwich here. Miss Crawford!
Well, what are we breaking?
Because Miss Crawford didn't make her entrance because you didn't notice, Mr. Observance.
Miss Crawford's stone deaf. She can't hear the other actors and never makes her entrance in case you didn't notice, Mr. Director.
I am tired of carrying her through the show, Victor. I was hired to play one role. Not two.
A little respect for Miss Crawford, please.
How does my makeup look?
It looks fine, Queen Elizabeth.
Miss Crawford!
Miss Crawford!
Miss Crawford!
Miss Crawford!
Lady Barrington!
Lady Barrington!
Now? Is it me?
Oh, it's all right, Miss Crawford. If you can't hear the other actors from back there, perhaps you could see them. We can use a sight cue.
What?
I said perhaps we could use a sight cue!
I'm waiting for my cue, darling!
Is this all right?
What?
Do you think you could project a little?
Mr. LePew, I learned to project on a mountaintop with pebbles in my mouth reciting Shakespeare to the winds.
Oh, sorry, Brinks, we haven't gotten winds here.
Yes, we do. Just stand behind her.
People, please. We haven't even made it through the first half of the play. When you are speaking with Miss Crawford, just yell your brains out.
I hardly think yelling my performance is the answer.
The answer is mercy killing, but we open tomorrow.
Shall we take it from my entrance?
In just a minute. Philip, perhaps we can just push her out from the back.
Yes, Mr. LePew.
While we are stopped, may I give a few notes? Must could tell the other actor. What the hell does that say?
Mouthing the actors again.
Ah, yes. Candy, sweetheart, darling, you're mouthing the other actors' lines again, dear.
I know.
I know, too. I saw it.
That's how I remember my lines. I
hear the other actors' voices in my head, and then I know when to speak.
Then perhaps you can say their lines in your head with your mouth shut, or shall I staple your lips shut?
I'll say their lines in my head with my mouth shut.
Oh, I'm so glad. Miss Monet, if you insist on bowing each time that you make an entrance, perhaps your first entrance shouldn't be until curtain call.
Are you correcting me in front of the cast, dear?
I'm merely suggesting.
Face it, LePew. When I enter, people will stand and applaud.
Darling, you haven't worked since your TV series in 1987.
Everyone Loves Mona was top 10 for 2 years. We beat the pants off Dharma and Greg. Jenna Elfman still doesn't speak to me over it.
But this is theater, Mona. Applause must be earned by your years of dedication to the theater. Besides, if they're gonna applaud for anyone, it's gonna be for me.
Try saying Penelope 3 times fast.
Mr. LePew!
Mona! Frank, please, we do not need this petty sniveling. I cannot tell you how much we all need this. All of us. Mr. Banks has believed enough in our collective talents to bring this play to New York. Now, perhaps it isn't Broadway. It's not even off Broadway. But it is theater!
There isn't even a sink backstage.
Miss Apples? Candy?
Huh?
Please leave the gum off stage.
It relaxes me to chew gum.
Well, little British ingenues don't chew gum. Little porno stars from Van Nuys chew gum.
Mr. LePew,
I don't think it's necessary to call Candy names.
I'm not calling her names, you asshole.
What did he call me?
A British ingenue.
Don't call Mr. Banks. I didn't mean it. Candy, the gum could work.
Piggy! Mr. LePew is upsetting me, Daddy!
Daddy, is Mr. Banks your father?
No.
Ooh.
What the hell is going on this time, LePew, you overpaid psychopath?
Mr. Banks, just a little directorial criticism. I was just explaining to Miss Apples that little British ingenues just do not chew gum.
Well, it's innovative.
What?
That's what I want. I want different angles. Different angles are money in the bank, and that's what we're all here for, isn't it?
That's what you're here for, Piggy.
The name is P.G. Banks, LePew. Let me tell you something. If it weren't for me, you'd still be in the booby hatch, twitching and drooling in a corner somewhere. You want to insult people, why don't you start with the ham and all that Shakespeare training? What the hell's the matter with you? The name is Penelope. A moron can say that. Say it.
Penelope.
See? Moron can't say it. What's your problem?
It's one of those vicious blocks, Mr. Banks. A mental block.
A what?
Nothing. Slip of the tongue. I have a password, but now I'm just tripping over it.
Cut it out. You sound like a jackass.
Yes, sir.
Repeat after me. Pen.
Pen.
L.
L. P. P.
Penelope.
Penelope B.
Fine.
Since we're stopped, I'd like to know what happened to Hal Holst. He was good in the role. This girl... No offense, Dick. Stakes.
Well, I didn't want to upset you all, but Hal Holst was brutally murdered after rehearsal.
Why?
Not to worry. Luckily, Miss Scorsese here happened to be available.
Available? She's a TV repairman!
I've seen a lot of plays with my cousin. I think anyone can do it, and if you ask me, there's really nothing to it.
No one is asking you.
Well, that's what I think.
Oh, is that what you think, Dick?
And Dick's cousin? Martin Scorsese will be in the audience.
Welcome to the show, Dick. You're marvelous in the role you really are.
Mr. Banks, I was thinking of using a French accent.
No, Mr. Looney, I've already told you no quite emphatically.
French. I like it.
It's a British murder mystery.
So what?
Why would the butler be French?
Oh, France is right next door. He could be a commuter. He could wear bread.
Mr. Banks, I was hired to direct this show. Need I remind you of my past laurels?
Need I remind you of your past fiasco? The one that landed you in the booby hatch, that $200 million bomb? The musical comedy story of a tsunami that destroyed Thailand? Wave goodbye to Daddy? They flooded the audience with debris and little children's shoes.
I have directed some of Broadway's greatest successes under the veranda.
Life beneath the roses.
Life beneath the roses.
Amerio Galileo!
Amerio Galileo!
Wave goodbye to Daddy. Now get in place and run this damn thing through! I gotta go take a whiz.
I still can't hear you, David! Richard Burton always knew I'd reject.
I am fine. Places, please, for Miss Crawford's entrance.
Mr. LePew, I was...
You just... listen here, you little dildo. You use a French dialect, I'll shove my foot right up your accent.
Okay.
Any notes for me, Mr. LePew?
Yes, Philip. You must make sure that the snow machine is working consistently. The entire message of the show rests on the consistency of the snow.
Okay.
Places, please. Well, show them. This will be another Victor LePew triumph. Philip, give me a place.
Juries can be bought. You never did explain that blood on your socks.
I know my lines.
Action, lights, start, damn it!
Aha! Juries can be bought. You never did explain that blood all over your socks.
Mr. Barrington, your mother cannot wait to see you. I told her you had arrived and her face lit up like the shining sun. And everything. Presenting Lady Barrington. Presenting Lady Barrington!
I forgot where you're staying!
Mother, it's been so long.
I'm excited, my boy. You've come home.
Brent.
What?
Brent.
Brent, my boy. You've come home.
For Christ's sakes.
I don't know how to tell you this, son. But Daddy is dead. He died. Eating cheese. Gouda cheese.
I know, Mother. That's why I've come.
What is this?
Mother, this is my new bride, Pen La Pee Pee.
Such a pretty child. So young. So sad. How old are you, my dear?
23 1/2.
Pretty!
If you knew what was good for you, you'd take the first train out of here.
It's too late! That was the last train leaving the station!
Good one, Philip!
The trains are not running because of the snow. We are all trapped here like rats in a pack.
What does it matter? She's in the family now. There's no escape from her fate. Your fate is sealed, my dear.
Especially in the snow.
Inspector Mouse!
What?
You're still here.
And so we all are. I'm glad to have you all here. I found conclusive evidence which will conclusively point to the killer of Lord Barrington.
Ah!
Please be seated.
Alabama Miller, I don't believe you know everyone.
What have you done to my play a lifetime?
torment to bury my soul, and you just slashed the guts out of it.
Oh, when did you get out of the rehab center, Miss Miller?
Play him up, Looney.
Why did she dress like that? Choir robes, people! Everyone in the place should be wearing choir robes!
Alabama! If there is one thing that I know how to mount, it is a show! Now, I've taken your soul, as you so nicely put it, and embellished it with the style that only a Victor LePew could give it. Now, not only is it a dramatic triumph, but a commercial triumph as well. People, they'll take one look at this show and say, LePew! LePew!
I represent women's repression and the new sexual freedom. Isn't that right, Mr. LePew?
Oh, yes, yes, that was a statement that was screaming to be made.
Besides, Mr. Banks' TNA will goose the box office.
There comes a time, Miss Miller, when it's best to just go with the flow.
Go with the flow? My play was 576 pages. Now it's 18 pages, and that includes the props list.
Yes, but now we can do 3 shows a night.
Changed my title.
Drop Dead is a catchy title.
It's not my title. The World Condition of Eternal Snow God. That's the title. It summarizes the whole point.
I don't get it. Sounds stupid.
What the hell is she doing here? I left word not to let her in.
How you feeling, Alabama? There's a bottle of scotch in my office. Go help yourself.
Oh, doesn't she look great? Turn around for me, baby. Woo. I tell you, these new bits I inserted make this whole show work.
About that line you had, Mr. Banks, about the, massively large jugs.
What? Massively large jugs? What line? You can't do that.
Why not? You got the inspector pulling out a bra.
You know, the bra represents human sexuality.
And the snow?
The eternal seasons of life. People facing the same battles generation after generation. The same snow that touched Earth during the time of Christ touches us now. It's the common denominator.
Good, that's how I was playing it.
Yeah. And the dead body on stage, the ever-present specter of death that looms over us all. I don't get it.
I don't either. That can't be right.
Can't be right. I wrote the play!
Cheer up, Miss Miller. You know how many playwrights ever even get produced? You didn't think about that, did you, now?
I'll kill you. I'll kill you.
Oh, get in line!
If I hear Alabama Miller interrupting my rehearsal again, I want her thrown out of the theater. Got it, piss boy?
Yes, sir.
Hey, who's up there? Who's up there?
Nobody's up there!
My God! I was almost killed! Doesn't anyone care about me? Well?
Are you all right, Mona?
If I didn't know any better, if I wasn't so loved by us all, I'd swear that sandman was deliberately dropped to kill me!
Who would want to kill you? No one even remembers who you are.
That rope was cut! First Hal Holston, now me!
We should call the police!
No police! I'm not sure.
What?
I mean, I'm not that sure. It was a silly little mistake. It's over.
I was almost killed. You call the police, or I'm calling my agent.
Over my dead body! Nothing interferes with this show opening tomorrow night. You hear me? Nothing!
Can we get a move on? Some of us have to get up in the morning and go to work for a living.
Miss Scorsese is right. Places, please!
I'm supposed to say that! Places, please!
But gee, I...
Thank you all for being so understanding.
Take it from... What's the line, Philip?
I got it. It's...
Murder!
Well, we know it's not Inspector Mounds.
Then it must be someone in this room. I feel faint.
You should lie down, Penelopus. I'll take you off to rest. Where should we go to rest, Jules?
Any place but the study.
It's occupied.
Mother, will you be all right?
With you gone, at least she'll be alive.
Why, you dirty bitch! Ah!
The truth always hurts.
I'll be back, Mother. Stay alive until I do.
I will, son. I will.
A drink for Lady Barrington.
I live to serve you.
I guess this leaves us quite alone.
Quite.
And I suppose we'll never know what Inspector Mounds was supposed to tell us.
And I suppose that serves you just fine, Mother. Doesn't it?
Why do you say that, Bet?
You think I don't know, don't you? About you blackmailing Daddy with those horrid photographs of him in the Brownie Troop earning special merit badges in the woods?
So what? You're horrid, bro! And you won't be surprised to know that you've been cut out of your father's will and left to me! Me alone!
The drinks, Mum. Shake it by hand.
Thank you, girls.
You think everyone's your servant, don't you, Mother? You pompous, money-hungry society bitch!
Stop it! Hold your places!
Could we please go on without stopping?
You should have said something sooner, Bet.
We've stopped.
Now I see you as
we've stopped.
When Miss
Crawford!
Die,
we've stopped! Miss Crawford! Miss Monet, you have the most pathetic stage slap I have ever laid my eyes on.
I don't do stunts.
Slap her.
Victor, I'm afraid of hurting her. She's ancient.
A proper stage slap does not hurt the actor. You should know that. Philip, come out here.
Yes, Mr. LePew.
There. See, that didn't hurt, did it, Philip?
Not at all, Mr. LePew.
The meat of the neck cushions the blow, so you may slap away to your heart's content.
Oh, Mr. LePew.
Now may we go on with our little opus before my hair turns white and I look like Anderson Cooper, for Christ's sake?
Fine. You correct me in front of the cast again, and I walk.
No one walks out on Victor LePew. Take it from...
the slap.
Take it from... the slap. The places!
You think everyone's your servant, don't you, Mother?
What?
We've started.
What?
We've started!
Have we started?
You pompous, money-hungry...
Shall we take it from my entrance?
I've started, I'm acting, I'm attempting to perform.
I'm sorry, am I in the right spot, Mr. LePew? These young actors of yours move all around space with no respect for your blocking.
I am in the same spot, I've always been in.
Oh.
You think everyone's your servant, don't you, Mother?
Shall we begin?
You pompous, money-hungry, senile society bitch! Oh, was that better?
Is she still alive?
Yeah, she's fine. Victor, her, my private.
Keep going.
You should have said something sooner, Bet. Now I see you as you really are. When I die, I'll see to it that you are cut out of my will, just as you were cut out of your father's entire inheritance.
Before you do, here's your drink.
I brought a sheep to inspect the mounds. It's on your bed, Bet.
What? How appropriate.
Cheers! The lights! The lights are fading! The room! Girls, don't forget to get some new bulbs! The room is spinning! I can't catch my breath! The lights are fading! The lights are out!
What are you trying to say, Mother?
She said it tastes delicious.
Good God! She's dead!
Nonsense! She's just sleeping! Wine tires her so.
How wrong you are, Bet. Unless I've missed my mark, her hot toddy has been spiked with a lethal dose of arsenic. I happen to be an amateur botanist.
Seems open and shut?
Yes. But to be safe, I shall call for the police. The telephone is dead! Father is dead, Mother is dead, Inspector Mounds is dead, and now the telephone! This is the final straw. I refuse to stand by and watch those picked off one by one like a bunch of soldiers. I will nobly sacrifice my life in the blinding snow to save what's left of my home, my family, and the snow.
How do we know that you aren't the killer? I saw the way you looked at Jules, in that special way.
I'll not sit here and listen to your lies another moment better. Take your hands off me! I must go! I must go! I am going!
You are going?
I will go through the back!
Philip! Philip, get out of here and fix the set!
Mr. LePew, we haven't got 2 minutes without you interfering.
What's the problem, Shakespeare?
Just once, I'd like to rehearse with some continuity. At Arena Stage, you never stop for inferior set design.
Inferior? I like that.
Don't listen to him, Philip. You did a great job with the budget that you were allowed.
You tried building a set for $35, Mr. Big Time Actor!
You're just a professional for us here, Mr. Regional Theater.
Look, I gotta be in the shop at 9 in the morning. Fix the damn doorknob and let's do this thing.
Oh, yeah, let's go. Ooh, do something about Sharon Stone over here, huh? You wanna turn the audience's stomach with her laying like that? You can see up to China. We're not putting up a geriatric peep show here.
Philip! Get the doorknob on!
Mona, watch it when you slap her, right? You wanna knock her teeth into the front row, you can blind the audience with porcelain.
Listen to him, Mona.
I'll fix Mr. LePew.
Alright, let's go! Burning up the juice.
Philip, go out to the store and buy a small headset for Helen Keller's grandmother. We can pipe her lines from backstage.
Brilliant idea, Mr. LePew.
Places, please. Take it from... What's the line, Philip?
Foolish, heroic madman. He'll die of frost before he reaches the rope.
Bet. I know my lines. Mm-hmm. Foolish, heroic madman. He'll die of frost before he reaches the road. Yes, my darling brother. It was I who murdered father. But you see, I had to. He wouldn't share his cheese with me. Gouda cheese, sliced thin. And mother, you couldn't keep your hands off him. You loved rubbing in the fact that I couldn't find a mate. You had father. Alexander had all those women. Jules had his blow-up dolls. But me? What did I have? Nothing. Just a stable full of horses and a lot of dreams. Just a stable full of horses and a lot of dreams. That's all I had. And that's all you're getting.
Where the hell is Shaz Mooney?
I don't know. I was at the store.
Stage managers don't say I don't know.
Shaz, get your ass out here!
Oh, what the hell was that?
That was god awful. That's what that was.
Don't move! I'll kill you! I'll murder you! I'll beat you until you bleed! And I'll fire you!
Help me save me, Candy!
Tiki, don't! We couldn't help it! It was bigger than both of us! What?
It's true!
It's true.
Get your ass out of my theater! You'll never work again! I'll blackball you! You are finished in this business!
You think he had a future?
Please, Mr. Banks, it's my first year at Gray! Please, don't fire me!
This is pathetic.
Mr. Banks, we cannot fire Mr. Looney! We open tomorrow night! We will never replace him in time!
Mr. Banks, please, my show cannot withstand another change. You've done enough to it. At least let us get by opening night critics!
God, let us get by tomorrow night at least! If we do not make it past the critics, it could be a flop!
Flop?
None of us can afford to fail. I am Victor LePew. I am the director, but I have clippings. Fill up my pills!
Look, Cousin Marty's gonna be out front tomorrow night. He likes it. Goodbye, movie rights.
Look. Listen, Jazzhole. I'm a kind-hearted individual. You got tomorrow night. After that, your history.
I spent weeks rehearsing.
Take it or leave it.
Take it!
Mr. Banks, I'd just like to say it's an honor to do one night of your show.
Places, people! From Drool's entrance!
Dr. Banks is killing our show.
Candy, I want to be speaking on you. After rehearsal, I'll be in your dressing room, waiting.
Yes, Daddy.
I hate you.
Places!
It's me!
You're dead!
I am?
You're dead!
I always thought of it like this. Where's Hughes? Where's Lawrence and Jessica? We have so much you can't show from.
Go!
Just a stable full of horses and a lot of dreams. What is wrong with you?
I can't help it, Mr. LePew.
You are ridiculous.
Stop crying, damn it!
I'll try!
Policeman?
Born to serve, Miss Bet. And today, I serve the call of justice.
Drop that gun!
Very clever, Miss Bet.
Foolish, ignorant, misguided manservant.
What a sad day. Barrington's.
I couldn't sleep. I thought I heard a noise.
Really?
What's happened to Jules?
Hunting accident.
Funny. With that expression on his face, he almost looked like, by Jove, I thought he looked familiar.
What are you babbling about?
My brother Whip, my little brother Whip, who was stolen in infancy by a band of wandering raccoons. I searched high and low for him for many years.
Well, now you've found him, and I hope the two of you are very happy together.
Drop that gun, you conniving bitch!
Never!
Look out, Alexander, look out!
Wait a minute, wait a minute!
What now?
She is standing right in front of me. They are paying to see Mona Monet. I think they should at least get to see my face when I die.
Oh, Mona, don't worry. They're going to be watching you die all night long.
Up yours, Pen Lepipi.
Mr. Lepew, am I the only professional in this company? Can we please go on?
Oh.
What are these made out of anyway? Candy?
Sugar.
Sugar candy! Like me!
Oh my god, can we please just go on?
Okay.
Can I have the entire company on stage for some notes?
Get up!
It's gonna take a while. I gotta be at the shop at 9 in the morning.
Miss Miller, do you have any notes for the company?
My life is over. Beating myself, what's required?
Thank you, Miss Miller. Kids, we have a super show here. It is pure LePew.
What are you planning on doing?
Philip! Miss Crawford, try this on. You can conceal it under your wig, and no one will know the lines are, right? Let's try it at least once. People, places, please. From Lady Barrington's first entrance!
No! No!
My God! Philip, don't go back there!
He's dead!
What? Oh, God!
No one's back there! But there has to be!
I'm telling you, no one's back there!
That means someone of us!
Oh my God! He's dead!
You mean... murder!
Cheese in the library. Brie cheese. Sliced thin. I am Drool, the French butler. Oh. I have slaved for this family since I was a young boy, as my father did before me, and his father before him, and my grandmother beside him, and my mother beneath her. Ah, the door is chiming. I must answer it, as I have done since I... Hey, why don't I just answer the door? Ah, Monsieur Alexander Barrington!
Ah, Drools. Kindly Drools. Ever faithful, ever true.
And who is this young mademoiselle I see before me?
Drools, I'd like you to meet my new bride, Phyllis.
The light is mine, as well as young Alexander's, I've no doubt in my French mind.
Ah, Jules, it's a sad day for the Barringtons.
May I take your coats?
Is mother about?
She's been under quite a strain, finding the lawn like that, face down in the brie, sliced thin.
Poor mother.
Poor thing.
How is she?
Hasn't touched a dairy product since. Not even le yogurt.
And my sister. Bat. Has she arrived yet?
She's come, sir. Arrived this morning, singing Alouette, Jante, Alouette.
How odd.
Not as odd as having a French butler.
Life is strange. Ah, seems the Lady Barrington is up and around. May I take your suitcase? Oh, please help yourself to the sherry. It will warm you from the winter chill.
There's a chill in the air. Chill about this house, Alexander. An evil chill. I'm frightened. Help me. Help me.
You're all right, as long as I'm around, Penny Loafer.
I feel better knowing that you're near.
I'll never leave you. Never. The snow. White snow. Falling snow. Snow everywhere. Snow. Each flake different and unique in a melancholy way. Yet together. A mass of constant white.
What are you trying to tell me, Alexander?
I was born and raised in this house, Pippi. I lived here my entire life, with the exception of school, and college, and day camp, and the week I was kidnapped by the man in the blue mask. This home is my blood. This home and the snow. There's nothing I wouldn't do to keep. Nothing.
Anything? What do you mean by anything? Nothing.
She means nothing.
Oh. Who the hell are you? And who the hell are you?
Me?
Yes. No, I mean yes.
Inspector Mounds. I am the ghost of Lord Barrington, here to make sure everything is said correctly. I am the ever-present specter of death that looms over us all.
Beg your pardon?
Inspector Mounds, Scotland Yard. I'm here investigating your late father's death. It seems he was a bit of a musical fellow, wasn't he?
And what have you found? We have nothing to hide here.
Nothing. Everything comes from nothing. All of time comes from a single point. A man who has nothing has everything. A man who has it all has less. A man with nothing is everything. I give my all. Nothing?
Nothing that can't be explained.
Explained?
And what else do you know, Inspector?
Well, we know your late father didn't die accidentally.
You mean...
murder!
Oh, Alexander, hold me, touch me, thrill me.
Looks like snow.
Would you mind answering some questions, Mr. Barrington?
I have nothing to hide.
What has a man to hide if he hides himself? The reading of the tale will tell the will. I mean, the reading of the will will tell the tale.
Meaning?
Exactly. What was your sister Beth's relationship with your late father?
Marvelous, Inspector. We got along divinely. I miss him so. It's hard to believe he's really gone.
He's still here, in a way.
Filet mignon! He's not really gone. He's still in his study. They haven't come for the body yet. Snow and all.
Hello, brother.
Hello, Bet.
Who are you?
I am the ghost of your father, the ever-present specter of death that looms over us all.
You must be the new one.
Bet, this is Po-Po.
That's a lot. What did you mean, new one?
Yes, I didn't quite catch that myself.
Didn't dear brother tell you? You're number 13. Unlucky number 13.
13? 13 what?
Why, 13 wives, you little unsuspecting fool.
I thought I was the first.
Naive, foolish, petulant child.
You are the first penicillin, the first that meant anything.
What happened to them, Alexander? Were they pretty?
They were all lovely. Especially Gwendolyn, with her fair skin, tight sweaters, and massively large jugs.
Strike that!
Where are they now?
She was buried with them.
You mean?
Dead.
You mean?
Murder!
I always meant
to... Taking of a life. So simple, so free, and yet so binding and confusing. How can one judge a murderer unless he himself has murdered? Whose values of good and evil are the norm? What if our sense of values are based on the wrong standards? Who's to say whose values are good and evil? I believe that this is one lesson that my son and daughter have learned at this very moment. If only they could cut the ties that bind them. Interesting, Mr. Barrington. If you'll excuse me.
Juries can be bought. You never did explain that blood on your socks.
Escargot! Monsieur Barrington, your mother cannot wait to see you. I told her you had arrived and her face lit up like the face of a gentleman at the Folies Bergère. Presenting Lady Barrington.
Okay, Miss Crawford, Walk over to the sofa and turn around.
Mother, it's been so long.
Say, Alexander, my boy, you've come home.
Alexander, my boy, you've come home.
I don't know how to tell you this, son.
I don't know how to tell you this, son.
But Daddy is dead.
But Daddy is dead.
He died eating cheese.
He died eating cheese.
Gouda cheese, sliced thin.
Gouda cheese, sliced thin.
I know, Mother. That's why I've come.
What is this?
What is this?
Crossing. Go to Penelope.
Go to Penelope.
What?
Do it, damn it.
Do it, damn it.
They're very well, Mother. This is my new bride, Pennsylvania.
Such a pretty child. So young, so sad.
Such a pretty child. So young, so sad.
How old are you?
That's none of your goddamn business.
What is?
23 1/2.
What?
Pity.
Pity.
If you knew what was good for you, you'd take the first train out of here.
Hold on a minute.
Hold on a minute.
What?
Son of a bitch!
Son of a bitch!
No!
The trains are not running because of the snow. We are all trapped here like Napoleon at Waterloo.
Say, there is no escape from her fate. Your fate is sealed, my dear.
There is no escape from her fate. Your fate is sealed, my dear.
Point to the window.
Point to the window.
What?
Point to the window!
Point to the window!
Especially in the snow.
Inspector Mounds, you're still here.
And so we all are. I'm glad to have you all here. I found conclusive evidence which will conclusively point to the killer of Lord Barrington. Please be seated.
Sit down.
Sit down!
You're ruining everything!
You're ruining everything!
We are going to fire you!
We are going to fire you!
What? Get off!
Get off!
Shut up!
Shut up!
Go on, Inspector!
Miss Crawford, walk to the archway. We are going to replace you.
We are going to replace you!
Replace who?
Go on, Inspector!
Right.
Yes! Go on, Inspector! I haven't been myself lately.
Right. The murderer is someone in this room! Huh? I found these two items on the body of the Lord, buried in the Gouda, sliced thin. This letter, and this brassiere.
Ooh la la.
I'm free! The ever-present specter of death cannot be held back by the binds of life. The contents of this letter, written in the murderer's own hands,
the handwriting is on the wall. Our society has been forewarned.
Along with this brassiere,
the mark of human sexuality carried with us through life, much like a perfectly proportioned hand-carved in mahogany cadenza. And yet so often we neglect to polish our credentials. Are there none so stiff as those who will not listen? None so short as those who will not grow? I believe that this is one lesson our inspector has come to, and this her final hour.
Right. The murderer is none other than...
What the hell was that? Good God! She's dead! Oh, that's not supposed to happen! Good God, she's dead! Two.
You mean...
Murder! Two.
You bet your ass it's murder! We should have called the police when Banks got killed! I told you!
Now, I know it's hard to accept Father's ghost's death, but we must go on. The eyes of the world are upon us now, in our hour of grief.
What?
I said, the eyes of the world are upon us. We must go on.
How about you all, brother? Some might even be casting a critical eye upon us.
Morning! Morning!
Need we review any further?
Oh, where were we?
Well, we know it's not Inspector Mounds, or do we?
Well,
we know it's not Lord Barrington.
That's true. There he is, the ever-present specter of death who looms over us all.
Then it must be someone in this room.
I feel faint.
Me too. You should lie down in the slips. I'll take you all to rest. First, we go to rest, Jules.
Can I go with you?
Nope.
Any place but the study. It's occupied.
Mother, will you be all right?
You, God, at least she'll be alive.
Why, you dirty bitch!
The truth always blows.
Mother, I'll be back. Stay alive until I do.
I will, son. I will.
Hey!
Why don't you take that with you when you will?
Very well, Jules.
Let's go, kid.
You must go.
We'll go with you.
No, you won't.
thin. And mother.
I knew it! I told them!
I mean, yes! You couldn't keep your hands off him! You loved rubbing in the fact that I couldn't find a mate. You had father. Alexander had all those women. Drools had his blow-up dolls. But me? What did I have? Nothing. Just a stable full of horses and a lot of screaming streams.
Thank you for that lovely confession, Mona, I bet.
Drools, you are butler and not a policeman.
I don't care. Drop your gun.
What?
Drop your gun, please! Don't hurt me!
Foolish, ignorant, misguided manservant!
Ah!
Stay still!
No!
Foolish, ignorant, misguided manservant!
Save me! Help me!
I've got you now!
Please! Oh, please!
I couldn't sleep. I thought I heard a noise. What's happened to Jules? Chaz! What did you do to him?
Nothing yet.
He's only leaving the stage.
He's alive. He's alive.
What?
Inspector Mounds, I thought you were dead.
Huh?
Oh.
It's the clever ruse. One of those clever ruses. I have discovered who the real murderer is. It's your other little brother, Philip.
Who?
Your other little brother, Philip.
The brother who was also stolen in infancy by a band of wandering raccoons?
Exactly.
I have also searched high and low for which little brother Philip all these many years, too.
Well, now you've found him. And I hope the three of you are very happy together.
Drop that gun, you conniving bitch!
Never!
Look out!
You're working with! He is Victor LePew!
child of the Broadway stage.
Nobody treats him like this.
Genius is never recognized in its own time. Why is that? Why? I dedicated my life to getting him back on top. And by millions. Someday they'll see why I had to do what I did to save the show. It was all up to me!
Looks like snow.
It's going, Jules.
Oh, Jules, weren't you frightened?
Just a little.
Oh, poor Philip, blinded by the love and artistic genius. Do you think they'll go easy on him, Inspector?
Are you out of your mind? He's a homicidal maniac who just brutally murdered four innocent people.
Well, one was a producer and the other was a playwright. Surely those two don't really count.
Do you mean to say you really are a policeman, Inspector?
Yes, Miss Beth. Detective Dick Scorsese, NYPD. I've been investigating the murder of piss poor actor Hal Host. By going undercover here as Inspector Mounds, I've been able to spy on each and every one of you. Sooner or later, we knew the murder strike again. And this time, we'd be ready. So, my search is over.
And we can go on with our lives.
Oh, Alexander, help me! Help me!
And the snow has melted at last.